Keswick Motor Museum in Cumbria, where the cars are the stars of the show. So here's Mad About Motors. I've got the weirdest feeling I'm in a Colt 60 series.
You are indeed. You're in a Lotus Super 7, driven by Patrick McGowan in The Prisoner.
A bit of a tight squeeze for you.
Fantastic. I'm jammed in solid. There's no way I'm getting out of here.
Well, now we have to see a museum where the car is the star.
Oh, really? Where's that?
In Keswick.
Very nice. Onward.
Cars Museum in Cumbria has around 30 amazing motors that have featured in films and TV series, and it's the passion of one man, Peter Nelson. So this is the car that started it all, Peter.
Yes, this 1946 MGTC. I was driving this to my surgery one day, and a chap jumped out in front of me and he said, I wonder if we could borrow this for a TV series they were doing, Granada's The Spoils of War.
Yeah.
So I loaned them the car and really thought no more about it until this garage came up for sale, and I thought it should be a motor museum. I remembered that this was used in a TV series, and I thought, I wonder what happens to all the cars from TV and films. So I set off on an amazing adventure to track this type of car down.
But tell me about some of them.
For example, the Saints Volvo, all I had was the name of a person, so I went down to the post office again and listed every person with that name and started ringing them up, and I must have rung about 60 people until I found the car. And of course I was a schoolboy in the 60s, and all the 60s had fabulous cars, the TV series then, like the Avengers and the Saint and the Prisoner. And so, and all those people were my heroes. I was madly in love as a schoolboy with Diana Rigg. And so I was desperate to find the car that she actually used in the series.
This one looks familiar. Tell me about this one.
This is the Morris 8 Tourer from All Great Creatures Great and Small. I was keen to get a car from this particular series. And again, I knew where it was. It was in Manchester. But the chap didn't want to sell it. I went down and I tried to persuade him, but he wasn't going to part with it. In the end, we bartered until early hours of the morning, and I swapped him an Austin 7, a motorcycle, and a number plate. But I was determined to get that particular car, and so eventually I got it.
It's not just an English car as you have either, is it? You've got a few American movie star cars as well, like this one, the DeLorean.
That's
Back
right.
To the Future.
Early on, I mainly concentrated on the British cars because they were easier to get. But then later on, I started to move further afield. And of course, the main things were major films from Hollywood. And this is the car used in Back to the Future for all the promotional things that they did throughout Europe. So this was an important car to get.
Okay, thanks a lot, Peter. And now it's time for a tip from Jeff.
Well, the paintwork's tatty, so you're saving up or you're rushing with your chequebook to get a respray. You really don't need it most of the time. A bit of teakle, a little bit of elbow grease. It's amazing what you can actually do. All it needs is elbow grease, teakle, and a good rub. You put a bit of wax on after this. Keep moving your rag around. Put some wax on after this. I tell you what, you put a couple of £100 on the price of this tatty old Nova. That's what the car dealers do.
Now, if you were ever into Marvel Comics in the 60s, this Batman copy is perfect, an exact replica. But Keris has got a different idea.
Yes, indeed, this is more like it. The Batmobile that appeared in two of the most recent Batman films. And believe it or not, Peter's actually driven this monster around the streets of Keswick. Must have been quite an extraordinary sight. Now for something else quite extraordinary, our competition.
The answer to last week's competition was a water expansion tank. And Bernie Kelly of Manchester got it right and wins that Land Rover day out. Now, if you'd like to win a Formula One Super Team Scale Electric set, all you have to do is guess what part of the car this is and send your answer to the address being shown below.
Now, you may recognise this little beauty. It's Fab One, Lady Penelope's pink Rolls-Royce. And here it is in reality, all 22 foot of it. Now, this replica was actually made for Gerry Anderson for promotional purposes, but you can drive it, can't you, Jeff?
You can indeed, yeah. It's based on a six-wheeler coach.
and it actually worked. But it's the only vehicle, non-Rolls-Royce vehicle, to actually be able to carry the emblem, Spirit of Ecstasy, and the badge.
And the grill, without being sued.
Yeah, without being sued. Fantastic, isn't it?
It is, and it took a long time to find this car, and it's been very lovingly restored, hasn't it?
It has, by a firm in Biggleswade. And speaking of restorations, on with the Jag.
The Jag.
Interior's done, it's time to sort out the paintwork. My, how times have changed. See how clean and tidy this body and paint shop is? They don't normally do classic cars here, but as a special favour, they've agreed to do my Jag with the latest technology.
I tell you what, new technology is fantastic. What Derek's spraying on now is a stuff called slime. When your car first come in, they spray the whole car with this stuff. Water soluble, and it's just like cling film, to stop all the stray muck and paint going on your car. Just come round the back here, have a look at this. Peels off just like cling film.
And here's the Jag, all stripped down, primed and ready to be sprayed. Here they have the facilities to mix any colour of paint you want, so it was no problem for them to achieve the classic cardinal red shade of the Jag. Then they simply spray on the top coat here in this kiln, up to three layers, and bake it for 30 minutes until it's set. Simple as that.
I'm not going to show you the job finished yet. You've got to wait till next week, but believe me, you're going to be impressed.
This takes me back, Jeff. Chitty-chitty-bang-bang.
When you were a baby.
A very young girl. it's not a real car, though, is it?
No, it's not really based on anything. They built four of them for the movie, and this was the one that was actually used in the flying scenes. It's all Ford running gear.
Right.
There's a Ford 6, straight 6 engine in it.
So, are you ready for takeoff?
We're ready for takeoff. We're going flying. Are you...
I'm well stopped in.
Good girl. Here we go.
Sing the song now, Jeff.
Oh, you, chitty chitty bang bang, chitty chitty bang bang, please look.